Today, we're diving into the fascinating history and design of railway tracks. Have you ever wondered why railway tracks are built the way they are? From the ancient Roman Empire to modern high-speed trains, there's a rich history and a lot of science behind it. Buckle up because we're about to embark on a journey through time and technology. If you enjoy the video, let me know by liking and subscribing. Let me know what you like to see next, and let's get right into it. Our journey begins over 2,000 years ago with the Roman Empire. You see, the Romans were master builders known for their extensive network of roads and engineering marvels. But what does this have to do with railways, you ask? Well, it all starts with the width of Roman chariots. You see, Roman chariots were designed to fit within the ruts of Roman roads, which were typically about 4 feet and 8.5 inches wide. This width allowed for the efficient movement of military and trade vehicles across the empire. When horse-drawn tramways were developed in England during the 16th and 17th century, they adopted the same gauge, as the carts and wagons used the existing infrastructure. Fast forward to the 18th century, and we see the advent of tramways in mining regions. These wooden tracks guided horse-drawn carts carrying heavy loads of coal. The existing gauge from Roman roads was used because it fit the established carts, and it made sense to continue this practice. With the Industrial Revolution, the need for efficient transportation grew. The early railways, such as the Stockton and Darlington Railway in England, adopted the same gauge. George Stephenson, one of the pioneers of railway engineering, standardized this gauge when designing his famous locomotive, the Rocket. This gauge, 4 feet 8.5 inches, became known as the standard gauge and was widely adopted around the world. Let's take a moment though and let's break down the components of a railway track. The track consists of two parallel steel rails fixed to wooden or concrete sleepers, also known as ties. The gauge, or the distance between the rails, is crucial for stability and speed. The standard gauge provides a good balance between these factors, which is why it became the global norm. The rails are laid on a bed of crushed stone called ballast. The ballast provides stability, facilitates drainage, and helps maintain the track alignment. This foundation is crucial for the safety and efficiency of the railway. Building and maintaining railway tracks is also an intricate science. The alignment, curvature, and gradient of the track must be precisely calculated to ensure smooth and safe operation. Modern tracks are welded together to form continuous rails, reducing friction and allowing for higher speeds. Railway tracks often traverse challenging terrains, and engineers have to consider mountains, valleys, rivers, and even urban areas. This is where tunnels, bridges, and viaducts come into play. The construction of these structures requires advanced engineering techniques and meticulous planning. Take the Channel Tunnel, for example. This engineering marvel connects the UK and France, running beneath the English Channel. Building it required advanced technology and precise planning. Or consider even the iconic Golden Gate Bridge, which carries both cars and trains, showcasing the versatility of railway engineering. As technology advanced, so did the design of railway tracks. High-speed trains like Japan's Shinkansen and France TGV run on specially designed tracks that allow them to travel at incredible speeds. These tracks are straighter and smoother, with gentle curves to ensure passenger comfort and safety. You see, high-speed railways require precise engineering and maintenance. The tracks are welded together to form continuous railways, reducing friction and allowing for higher speeds. The infrastructure is designed to minimize curves and inclines, which helps maintain the track stability and speed. These trains can reach speeds of over 300 kilometers an hour, making them some of the fastest mode of transportation on land. Safety has always been a top priority in railway design. You see, modern railways use advanced signaling systems and automated controls to prevent accidents and ensure smooth operations. Innovations like positive train control and automatic train protection systems have revolutionized railway safety. Positive train control, also known as PTC, is a system designed to automatically stop a train before certain accidents occur, such as train-to-train collisions and derailments caused by excessive speeds. PTC systems use GPS, wireless radio, and computers to monitor train movements and ensure they adhere to safety protocols. This technology has been a game changer in enhancing railway safety. Railways aren't just for long-distance travels. Commuter rails, freight trains, and subways all play vital roles in our daily lives, and each type of railway is designed with specific needs in mind. Whether it's transporting people quickly across cities or moving heavy cargo across countries, commuter rails are designed to connect suburbs with city centers, reducing traffic congestion and providing a reliable mode of transportation for daily commuters. Freight trains, on the other hand, are the backbone of the logistic industry, moving goods efficiently across vast distances. Subways are integral to urban mobility, offering a fast and efficient way to navigate densely populated areas. In today's world, sustainability is key. Railways are one of the most eco-friendly modes of transportation, emitting less CO2 compared to cars and planes. Many modern trains are powered by electricity, and innovations in renewable energy are making railways even greener. Green rail initiatives are being implemented worldwide. Solar-powered trains like those in Australia harness the sun's energy to power their journeys. Electric trains are becoming more common, reducing reliance on fossil fuels. Projects like the Dutch railway system, which runs entirely on wind energy, demonstrate the potential for sustainable rail transport. Before going any further though, if you're still watching up to now, you most likely enjoy this video, and if that's the case, well, I need to ask you for a favor. You see, I'm trying to reach 2,000 subscribers by the end of August, and for that to happen, well, I need your help. So if you can just like and subscribe, that would be great. But if you want to share this video, make clips, or whatever else you want, well, that would be even better. But I'm not here to bother too much, so let's just get right back into railways, or actually, let's take a look at railway stations. You see, railway stations themselves are often architectural masterpieces, from the historic Grand Central Terminal in New York to the modern elegance of the Kyoto Station in Japan. These hubs are designed to be functional yet aesthetically pleasing, reflecting the culture and heritage of their locations. Grand Central Terminal, with its celestial ceiling and vast concourse, is a symbol of New York's rich history and bustling energy. The Kyoto Station, on the other hand, is a marvel of modern architecture, featuring sleek lines and an innovative design that integrates shopping, dining, and travel. These stations are more than just transit points, they are cultural landmarks that capture the essence of their cities. Railways have played a crucial role in shaping culture and economies worldwide. In India, the railways are a lifeline, connecting remote areas with urban centers and supporting millions of daily commuters. In Switzerland, the scenic railway routes through the Alps are a major tourist attraction, offering breathtaking views and a unique travel experience. Indian Railways is one of the largest and busiest railway networks in the world, serving over 23 million passengers daily. It has been instrumental in uniting the vast and diverse country, fostering economic growth and cultural exchange. In Switzerland, trains like the Glacier Express and Bernina Express offer travelers a chance to experience the natural beauty of the Swiss Alps, contributing significantly to the tourism industry, so the economy as a whole. The future of railway is filled with exciting possibilities. Trains, which use magnetic levitation to travel at ultra speeds, are being developed in countries like Japan and China. And while these trains aren't coming to the market anytime soon, they could potentially travel to speeds exceeding 600 kilometers an hour, offering a glimpse into the future of high-speed travel. So there you have it. From ancient Roman chariots to cutting-edge high-speed and maglev trains, the design of railway tracks have evolved tremendously. It's a blend of history, engineering, and innovation that keeps us moving forward. If you enjoy this video and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Let me know what you'd like to see next in the comments down below, and I'll see you on the next one.